Doc Rich back at it again, and next up on the surgeon's table today, oh man, Dax with the coronavirus, state of emergency. That's what we're going to be checking out today. Make sure you guys like, share, comment, and subscribe if you are new. Also, make sure you guys go and follow your boy on social media. The links will be typed up in the description box down below, where you guys can always feel free to DM me anything else that you would like to see, or if you just want to chat, well, we can do that too. But without further ado, my bro Dax, you next up on the surgeon's table. Let's get surgical with it, baby. Let's rock. Let's hear it. Since the World Health Organization won't say it, I will. The coronavirus is a global emergency. January 20. Oh, fuck. So he tweeted this. Did he really tweet this? Let me know. Or did he edit this joint? Let me know if y'all know in the comments. I follow his ass on Twitter, but I don't remember. You know what I'm saying? Let me know. Y'all be safe out there too, man, for real. He had to, because he circled it. Stay home. 100.
The next week is going to be our Pearl Harbor moment. It's going to be our 9/11 moment.
This was like last week, I think.
Moment for many Americans in their entire lives.
Yeah, this quarantine has got. Bro, this nigga brought this instrumental out. Oh shit! Hold on. Yeah, this quarantine has got me feeling like I'm locked in a prison. I got coffins for these beats. They better stay at a distance. Went to Costco for some tissue. They said two was the. Already.
I got coffins for these niggas. You better stay at a distance. Coffins. You bury these niggas, but also coffins. Stay at a distance. Social distance. Nigga. Say that again.
Yeah, this quarantine has got me feeling like I'm locked in a prison. I got coffins for these beats, they better stay at a distance. Went to Costco for some tissue, they said two was the limit. I saw granny try to get my hat to fight it to get it. Everybody's turning animalistic. No supplies, no. Bro, I did see some sad ass shit, man. Image of an older lady that was in an aisle that was completely fucking empty. And you know that, and I think I mentioned this, but that shit just broke my heart. Cause I know one day that's gonna be me. You know what I'm saying? One day that's gonna be all of us. That's gonna be that old individual, you know what I mean? That, you know, obviously ain't really got the pep in our step like we used to. And we gonna go to the store while something is going on. And because we ain't got the pep in our step and we able to be active and get to where we need to get to in a timely fashion like we need to, we ain't gonna have our shit. You know that, and that shit really hurt me, man. You know, like I said, not only because of that individual, that older lady, but because I know I'm gonna be in her shoes one day. And it's gonna be the same fucking result. I can have some wishful thinking, you know what I mean? But it's like, come on, man. Let's jump back into it. They get it. Everybody's turning animalistic. No supplies, no food. Next, the world's going cannibalistic. Going crazy, we all stuck on our phones. The quarantine, Macaulay Calkins, this a movie. We are home alone. We got bills, Mr. Gates. I wonder how the doctors feel. They gonna have to go in cannibalistic. Going crazy, we all stuck on our phones. The quarantine, Macaulay Calkins, this a movie. We are home alone. We got bills, Mr. Gates. I wonder how the doctors feel. They gonna have to go see Dr. Phil, Mr. Gates. By the way, if you've ever talked behind my back, that shit's okay. I might get sick if you come say it to my face. This shit's a pandemic, certified crisis.
That's okay. I might get sick if you come say it to my face. Coronavirus gets sick if you talk behind my...
Ha! Damn. Nigga spit.
This shit's a pandemic, certified crisis. I remember when Corona was a beer and not a man-made virus. I remember getting sick, wasn't shit. Now we panic when we cough, sneeze, or feel like we got any type of sinus. What we do now? Only option is to pray. If you don't want to be 6 feet under, stay six away. Stay home, hide your kids, wash your hands, be safe. It's like a greyhound bus and it's stopping in every state. Ain't it funny? How them kids think it's funny and they want to go and play on spring break. Stupid kids, they gonna sleep in a bed that they made and then be mad when them same springs that they had break. Can't escape, shit is viral. I was on it way before it hit the news. This is man-made, clickbaited, automated views. This is way more deadly than the flu. Way
stronger than the devil, even he couldn't empty the church pews. You a fool if you think it's fake. Haunt sex symptoms after 14 days until your lungs fail and you suffocate. Assisted reparation.
And you know, I don't know if I said it on the channel, but I said it to some people before, like, we started getting put on lockdown and all that, because people was like taking it as a joke, and I'm like, yo, I think this shit's serious, you know. And granted, most of us are healthy, so the virus itself may not kill you, but what about when you get pneumonia? Matter of fact, I think I was in the barbershop. And when this is all over, when this shit is all over, and shit is, you know, somewhat back to normal, we can get back to the barbershops and shit, I might actually record my barber telling y'all. I said this exact thing. The virus may not kill you. You know, for most of us, the virus may not kill you. But what happens when you get pneumonia and your lungs start filling up with fluid and you can't go to the hospital? Because there was 100,000 people that thought exactly the same as you, and they all got sick too, so they all in the hospital. So now you gotta die of suffocation because of some bullshit. I said that exact thing to my barber. Not the exact thing, but basically those exact words. And he'd tell you. And look what the fuck started happening. You know what I'm saying? And I hate the fact that it did, but like, sometimes you gotta take shit serious, man. Shit ain't always a joke. It's not always a joke, man. That's 100.
Flu, way stronger than the devil, even he couldn't empty the church pews. You a fool if you think it's fake. Haunt sex symptoms after 14 days until your lungs fail and you suffocate. Assisted reparation by a ventilator. Mass population declutteration, a reason to eliminate from Africa to Italy, Nigeria to Sicily. This virus 5G and has global connectivity, thieving in the night as it creeps in your vicinity and robs you of your basic motor function capabilities. So my task, before the world panics and runs out of all the masks, before discrimination of Asians becomes something we let pass, forgetting that the problem stems from something we can't grasp. Before you yell conspiracy, before you tweet at Donald like it's really gonna fix the situation, but you have no validity. Before the stocks plummet, before every industry realizes that its workers who slave actually run it. Before total lockdown and it's really gonna fix the situation, but you have no validity. Before the stocks plummet, before every industry realizes that its workers who slave actually run it. Before total lockdown and depression and anxiety, and long nights alone with no contact with society. The riots, the tanks, 90 days of sobriety and social validation off IG notoriety. Before you go crazy, way before you choose the worst time in mankind to have an unplanned baby, just know we're all part of the remedy. We on the same team. And Corona is the enemy.
That's a fact.
Stay home. Be safe.
We're on the same team.
And look out for each other.
100%. And listen, I don't know if this is true. Y'all can let me know in the comment section. But I think I saw somewhere in like China or something that some black people are being discriminated against because they blaming them for the virus. And I'm like, yo, whoa, wait a motherfucking minute. Pause, pump the brakes, my nigga. What? Y'all dead ass? Like, y'all dead ass. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, yo. Like, we went from blaming the Chinese people, which was totally unfair and uncalled for. You know what I mean? I don't normally speak out on shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Because y'all get me. But it's just like, come on, dog. We on the same fucking team, man. We on the same fucking team. If we don't learn to stand together, well, you know the end result. You know the end result. You know? I don't even want to say that shit. If we fail to stand together as a team, as one team, as a global fucking team, if we can't learn to fucking put our differences aside and understand that the fact that we are different is perfectly okay. We are one fucking team on this planet, on this earth. Y'all know the end result. We all do. I ain't gonna say it. Because I don't want to wish that upon anybody. But we know the likelihood of it. If we fail to work together as a team. You know? And I feel like for a while there, we weren't working together as a team. Once bodies actually started dropping, and it was starting to affect people on a personal level, once they seen their family members in the hospital because they couldn't fucking breathe, dying of suffocation, that's when motherfuckers started to take it serious. And I hope that this whole situation was a fucking wake-up call in that, like, not everything revolves around you personally. Sometimes you got to think about others. Do you think I fucking wanted to be cooped up in the house all fucking day long? Nigga, I ain't rich. My name might be rich, but I ain't fucking rich. I ain't living lavish. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no fucking palace that's, you know, 15,000 square feet where I got a fucking bowling alley and, you know, a fucking indoor pool and a fucking basketball court on the left wing and a tennis court on the right wing. And nigga, I ain't got all that. Nigga, I'm bored as hell, just like everybody else. I don't want to sit in the crib, but I know it's the best thing for me to do for all of us. It's not about me. It's not about me. It's about everybody. And I feel like some people were only thinking about themselves. I still see a few people still thinking about themselves and still trying to go about life as if ain't shit happening. I bet it's a lot of motherfuckers who on Easter went out. And because of that situation, we're going to have a spike in cases pretty soon here because of Easter. And motherfuckers going out when they knew good and well they shouldn't have. You know what I'm saying? So then we're going to be put on lockdown for even longer. You know, it's like we kids again. And, you know, that one kid ruins recess for all of us. You know what I'm saying? But man, shout out to Dex, man. Shout out to Dex. Coronavirus. Y'all stay safe, man. Stay safe. Stay home. Wash your hands. Health is wealth. Make sure y'all staying active as much as you possibly can. I know it's difficult. You know, some of us live in apartments and other things and have close neighbors. So I know that's difficult. But do what you can. Do what you can when you can. While staying safe, man. All right? But let me know what y'all thought about this joint in the comment section below. If y'all enjoyed the video, as always, leave a like before you go. Smack the subscribe button that's right over there, as you guys already know. And of course, family, check out the video that's right over there, too. You might like it. And I'm going to catch y'all in the next one. Doc Rich.